Hey, what's up? This is your girl Stacy of StacyLane.com, and you are watching Up and Coming Entertainment. If you're not up, you ain't coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, Up and Coming Entertainment, right now we have the beautiful Moni Devon. How are you? Now, Up and Coming Entertainment is no stranger to special guests like yourself. Tell the people out there what you do.
I have been an adult film star for over 7 years.
Wow.
I know that's a long time.
And you still could get a job too. Is there some that just fall off?
Yeah, there are actually quite a few that fall off. I'm technically retired, but we are looking forward to me maybe making a comeback into the industry. Oh, you look so disappointed.
How did you walk into this business?
I actually was at an ADN show. And I met quite a few people. Like, I believe the first person I met was Byron Long. And then I met Justice Blair, and everybody was just so nice and very convincing. And I mean, I was single, I didn't have any kids, so I figured, what the hell, why not?
And what was your very first scene on camera like?
It was horrible. I looked a mess. I did a great sex scene, but the rest of me just looked a mess.
And then after that, you got better experience.
Yeah, I guess you could technically say I got better experience. And I started watching porn. Like, before that, I really didn't watch a whole lot of porn. So I didn't know exactly what looked right and what didn't. So I started watching porn and kind of learning a little bit more about how to do a scene, you know, how to show up looking like you're going to do a scene. So yeah, with a little bit of experience, I got a lot better, obviously.
And who was some of your favorites you worked with in the business?
I would have to say, as far as girls is concerned, Jada Fire, D. I'm a huge fan of D. A lot of people don't remember. Is the Puerto Rican chick.
Yeah, I remember her.
Yeah, she's kind of old school. So I'm a huge fan of D. Mr. Marcus, definitely. Justin Slayer. I never had a problem with any of the guys like that. I've always liked all the guys.
So you had pretty much good experiences with everyone on set.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not going to say that. I can really, truly remember what I've had in that experience.
And what did you think of Two Girls in One Cup?
I personally wouldn't do that. It is not something I personally enjoy watching, but I feel like to each his own. You know, whatever you're into, this is what you're into. Yeah, I mean, I have never sat down and really watched it just because it's not something I'm into, but different people have different fetishes. And I'm not a judgmental person, so I feel like, you know, everybody, something out there for everyone. Somebody enjoys that, so so be it.
That's a little extreme to go to, but let's go to a normal subject. What does Moni like sexually?
Sexually, let's see. Well, inside the industry?
All around.
Or just, it's kind of hard to say because there's always a difference. There's something that you like inside the industry and then there's something that you like outside the industry because it is two different worlds. I would say inside the industry, I'm a little bit rougher. I like hands around my neck. I like to spit on. I like to be called bitches, whores, sluts, skanks. I'm into all that.
You like to be choked on?
Yeah, I love
to. What is this thing with choking? Like, I can't see myself doing that. Like,
I mean, well, it's the right way and the wrong way to choke a girl. Like, if you're not trying to kill her, you're not trying to strangle her, you have to be able to make it intimate. There is an intimate way to choke a woman.
Well, this is an educational show. Can you demonstrate what's the not so threatening way?
I can't technically demonstrate on myself, but it depends on where you put your hand. Like, if you give me your hand, you have big hands. So, you don't want to put your hand anywhere around the bone area, and you don't want to press into pressure points. You want to put your hands more towards the back. And if you're coming from the back, of course, you never want to press into this right here, because that's going to hurt her. You're going to have to hurt her and try to fuck her.
So basically, you can't put pressure.
No, do not put pressure into the pressure points. No, we all know that we have pressure points in our neck. So you have to be very aware of what you're doing while you're fucking at the same time. Some men get a little excited, they don't pay any attention. They're strangling you, and you're trying to get laid. So you have to be very aware of where your fingers go on a woman's neck.
That's all I can see myself doing.
It's fun. Everybody should try it.
Now, your personal side, what do you like personally?
Personally, I would say I'm a little bit more emotionally sexually at home. Like, I want to be caressed and kissed,
like,
and rubbed. And, yeah. But I'm versatile. First, you gotta start off making love, and then you gotta fuck me. So, you gotta be able to switch it up somewhere in the middle. Otherwise, I get bored.
That's how I see it. It's like a little bit of everything goes into it.
Yeah, definitely. You gotta know how to cross it.
And how do you protect yourself from all these cooties that are out here on set?
Well, as far as in the industry standard is that we get tested every 30 days. We have a regulated testing place, which is called AIM. It's AIM Healthcare Center. It was opened quite a few years ago by an ex-adult film star. What we do is we get our standard test, which is every 30 days, gonorrhea, chlamydia, and HIV. So everyone in the industry is definitely tested. You can't show up to set without your test. Personal-wise, I haven't done a scene, I would say, in almost a year. But yet, once you get used to getting tested every 30 days, you continue to get tested every 30 days. So the Department of Health out here sees me a whole lot.
What made you step out of the limelight?
Because what ends up happening with us is we get to a certain point where you see too much of us. You know, I can only do so many movies. I can only do so many series in those movies. Once you do 15 Sisters, you know what I'm saying? Or the cover of My Baby Got Back 3 times, what else is there left to do? I mean, only so many companies shoot so much. So sometimes it's just good to step back and, you know, give the fans a break and come back strong.
Because I wonder how long some of these titles are going to go by. I imagine 200 or
so. Oh, there are series out there that are, God, that are up to the hundreds. Like, there are series out there that are up to the hundreds. And I can see, as long as porn sells, they're going to keep shipping it.
Sex sells.
And it's gonna sell forever. So I can see something like Sister going up to 2,000. As long as there's new girls in the industry, then there's always something to shoot.
Do you like math problems?
No, not technically. I hated math in school.
It's one of my favorites. It's gonna be 2-part of the brain.
Okay.
68 plus 1, I like that.
Of course. But honestly, I prefer to do the giving than the taking.
Really? Don't have a selfish person here. Now, you was telling us about a reality show. Like, what made you decide to do that? Like, what direction you want to go?
As far as MonetDivineTV.com is concerned, I wouldn't technically call it a reality show, but then I guess you could. It just depends on how you want to look at it. I'm hoping to just give my fans a little bit more of me. Wake up in the morning with me, go to the store, we go grocery shopping, go find some pills. I don't know. Just your basic stuff. Just a little bit more of my life since I've been outside the industry. Because, I mean, you don't get to see